Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss spotting and image-based questions which are frequently asked in biochemistry practical examination. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit website biochemistrybasics.com. Before going in the detail of video, first of all I want to thank FitSport for including our YouTube channel in the top biochemistry YouTube channels available across the web. You can have access to this article by clicking on this link. First question is, identify the vacutes and write its use. So the first vacute is of K3 EDTA tube, which is used for the estimation of CBC and glycated hemoglobin, that is HbA1c. Second red color vacute is of pain vacute, which is used for the estimation of various biochemical parameters like RFT, LFT, electrolytes, hormones, and in serology testing. The third vacute, gray color vacute, is of fluoride vacute, which is used for the estimation of glucose because fluoride inhibits enolase enzyme. Second question is, identify the graph. So this graph is of oral glucose tolerance test. OGTT is done for the diagnosis of diabetes mellitus. In OGTT, three samples are collected. First sample is the fasting or 0 hour sample, and after the collection of fasting sample, 75 gram of anhydrous glucose is given to the patient, and then two samples are collected, first at 1 hour interval and second at second hour interval. Then all the values are plotted in the graph. So this is the graph of OGT. Third question is, identify the instrument and write its use. So these are the volumetric autopipette, which is used in quantitative estimation. Take exact amount of various body fluids like serum and reagents. So these are the pictures of volumetric autopipette. Fourth question is, identify the instrument and write its use. So this instrument is of calorimeter and it is used in quantitative estimation practicals in biochemistry. Fifth question is, write the components of calorimeter. So the components of calorimeter are light bulb, sleet, condenser lens, filter, cuvette, photoresistor, and galvanometer. So these are the components of calorimeter. Sixth question is, identify the instrument and write its principle. So this instrument is of calorimeter, and calorimeter works on Beers and Lambert's law. As per the Beers law, log ratio of incident light and emergent light is directly proportional to the concentration of the substance. If the length of the light path is constant, and as per the Lambert's law, log ratio of incident light and emergent light is directly proportional to the length of the light path if the concentration of the substance is constant. So this is the calorimeter which follows the Beers and Lambert's law. Seventh question is, again, identify the instrument and write its use. So this is the picture of urinometer, which is used to measure the specific gravity of urine. So this is the picture of urinometer. Eighth question is, identify the instrument and write its use. So this is the picture of electrophoretic apparatus with electrical supply. This electrophoretic apparatus is used for the separation of various plasma proteins, isoenzymes, and lipoproteins. Ninth question is, identify the instrument and write its use. So this is the picture of pH meter, which is used to measure the pH of various solution. Tenth question is, identify the condition and mention the associated mineral deficiency. So this is the picture of carpopedal spasm, which is seen in tetany, and it is associated with calcium deficiency. It occurs when calcium level is less than 7.5 mg per deciliter. Normal level of calcium is 9 to 11 mg per deciliter. Next question is, identify the mineral toxicity and name the clinical condition. So the mineral toxicity is of iron and the clinical condition is hemochromatosis. 12th question is, identify the sign and associated disease. So this is the KF ring, which is seen in Wilson's disease, and it is associated with copper. Next question is, identify the clinical condition and associated mineral. So this is the clinical condition associated with, again, copper, and it is Menkes kinky hair syndrome. It is the X-linked disorder, so it affects only males, and there is a deficiency of copper binding ATPase. So it is associated with. Identify the clinical condition and write the normal range of total, direct, and indirect bilirubin. So this is the clinical condition which occurs due to the accumulation of bilirubin. As you can see, yellowish discoloration of skin and sclera. If there is a yellowish discoloration of sclera, then it is also called as an icterus. So it is a jaundice. And the normal value of total bilirubin is 0.2 to 1.0 mg/dL. Direct bilirubin is 0 to 0.2 mg/dL, and indirect bilirubin is 0.2 to 0.8 mg/dL. Next question is, identify the disorder and write its causes. So this is the condition associated with vitamin A deficiency, and it is a xerophthalmia. In the xerophthalmia, conjunctiva is dry, scared, and wrinkled. So it is occurred due to the deficiency of vitamin A, which is a fat soluble vitamin. Identify the disorder and write its causes. So again, it is associated with vitamin A deficiency, and it is a keratomalacia. If xerophthalmia persists for a long duration, then it is converted to the keratomalacia, and the keratomalacia cornea is degenerated. Next question is, again, identify the disorder and write its causes. So it is a condition again associated with vitamin A deficiency. There is a triangular grayish white egg seen in conjunctiva. It is a mitote spot which occurs due to the vitamin A deficiency. Next question is, identify the disorder and write its causes. So it is the condition which is called as a rickets in children. Fine, and it occurs due to the vitamin D deficiency. As you can see, bow leg, knock knee, and pigeon like chest. So this is the rickets which is due to the vitamin D deficiency. Again, vitamin D is the fat soluble vitamin. Next question is, identify the disease and write molecular basis behind it. So this is the picture of RBC. As you can see, RBCs are the sickle shape. So it is a sickle cell anemia, and it occurs due to the replacement of glutamic acid is replaced by valine at the sixth place in the beta globin chain. So that is the molecular basis behind it. Identify the disease. So this is the case of thalassemia. These are the typical thalassemia faces, and these are the hair on end appearance seen in the skull of thalassemia patients in X-ray skull. Fine, so it is a thalassemia. And thalassemia is a hemoglobinopathy. There are two types of thalassemia, thalassemia major and thalassemia minor. Identify the disorder and write its causes. So it is the case associated with vitamin C deficiency, which is called as a scurvy. There is a bleeding gums and teeth are loose. So it is a scurvy which is associated with vitamin C deficiency. Identify the disorder and write its causes. So this is the disorder associated with vitamin B1 deficiency. There are the horizontal ridges on the nails, and there are the pigmentation. So it is the beriberi occurs due to the vitamin B1 deficiency. There are three types of beriberi: dry beriberi, wet beriberi, and mixed beriberi. Dry beriberi mostly affects the CNS, and the wet beriberi mostly affects the cardiovascular system. Identify the disorder and write its causes. It is the case associated with the deficiency of niacin, which causes pellagra. And pellagra is characterized by 3D, that is diarrhea, dementia, and dermatitis. There is a characteristic Kessel's necklace. So it is a case of pellagra which occurs due to the deficiency of niacin. Identify the instrument and write its use. So it is a glucometer, which is a point of care testing device, POCT device, which is used for the estimation of glucose. Identify the disease and write biochemical basis behind it. So this is the case of, as you can see, there is a deposition of uric acid crystals. As uric acid crystals are deposited in the synovial fluids of joints, then it leads to the gout, and it occurs due to the increased uric acid level in the blood. These are the uric acid crystals. So this is the case of gout. Identify the following test and write its principle. So this is the purple or violet color ring is seen at the junction of two liquids. So it is the Mollis test and it is the primary test done for the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates undergo hydrolysis in the presence of concentrated H2SO4 to get converted to the monosaccharides. And monosaccharides get dehydrated when treated with concentrated H2SO4 to form 5-membered cyclic compound, which is called as a 5-hydroxymethylfurfural, or its derivative, which condenses with alcoholic alpha naphthol to form a purple color complex at the junction of two liquids. Identify the following test and write its principle and use. So it is the test, Barfoot's test, which is done to differentiate between monosaccharides and disaccharides. And this test is based on reduction. In acidic medium, monosaccharide reduces cupric ions to form cuprous ion, while disaccharides are very slow in acidic condition. And this property is used in Barfoot's test to distinguish monosaccharides from reducing disaccharides. Identify the test, write its principle and use. So this is the Selivanov test. This test differentiates between aldose and keto sugar. And the Selivanov test distinguishes between aldose and keto sugars, and ketones on heating with dilute HCl gets dehydrated to form a furfural derivative, which on condensation with resorcinol produces cherry red color. So this is a Selivanov test. Identify the following test and write its interpretation. So this is the change in the color from blue to green to yellow to orange. So this is the test, Benedict test, which is done for the detection of reducing sugar. And the change in the color indicates approximate amount of sugar present in the solution. So if there is a blue color, that means absence of sugar, that is negative test. Green color, then 0.5 gram percentage sugar present in the solution. Yellow, that means 1 gram percentage. Orange means 1.5 gram percentage. Red means 2 gram percentage. And brick red means greater than 2 gram percentage reducing sugar is present in the solution. Identify the following test, write its principle and use. So this is the Biuret test, which is the again general test for the protein. And the principle is, in alkaline medium, cupric ion formed from copper sulfate reacts with peptide linkages of protein and forms purple color Biuret complex, which indicates presence of protein given in solution. Since more than 2 peptide linkages are required for the reaction, so dipeptides do not give the test positive. This is the control test. Identify the test and write its use. So this is the Rothera's test, which is done for the detection of ketone bodies in the given sample, specifically in the urine. And ketone bodies are seen in case of starvation and diabetic ketoacidosis. Identify and name the osazone. So these are the needle or broom shaped crystals. So it is glucose osazone or fructose osazone. Identify and name the osazone. So these are the sunflower shaped osazone. So it is a maltose osazone. Identify and name the osazone. So these are the powder puff osazone. So it is a lactose osazone. Identify the disease from the following graph. So this is the basically electrophoretogram. In normal patients, there are 5 bands are seen. First one is of albumin, then there is alpha 1, alpha 2, beta and gamma. But as there is also presence of M band in between the beta and gamma region, and this M band is specifically seen in multiple myeloma, which is a monoclonal gammopathy. So this is the case of multiple myeloma. Identify the incorrect enzyme from the given metabolic pathway. So this is the metabolic pathway which is associated with the breakdown of phenylalanine and tyrosine. So phenylalanine is converted to the tyrosine. tyrosine is converted to the para-hydroxyphenyl pyruvic acid, and para-hydroxyphenyl pyruvic acid is converted to the homogentisic acid. So incorrect enzyme is phenylalanine deoxygenase. Over here there is a presence of phenylalanine hydroxylase. So this one is the incorrect enzyme. Identify the metabolic disorder. So there is a black color urine, there is also black color deposition in the connective tissues, soft tissues and cartilages. So it is a case of alkaptonuria, which is occurred due to the deficiency of homogenticid oxidase enzyme. So it is the case of alkaptonuria. There is a black color discoloration of urine. There is a deposition of alkapton bodies in the pinna of ear, soft tissues, cartilage. So this is the case of alkaptonuria. Identify the structure and write down its normal range. So the structure, there is a presence of four rings A, B, C, D, three cyclohexane ring and one cyclopentane ring, and basically it is a cyclopentane per hydrophenanthrene ring. So it is a structure of cholesterol, which is derived from acetyl-CoA, and its normal range is 150 to 200 milligram per deciliter. So this is the structure of cholesterol. Name the enzyme catalyzing this reaction and its importance in the treatment of gout. So xanthine is converted to the uric acid. So this step is catalyzed by xanthine oxidase, and this xanthine oxidase is competitively inhibited by allopurinol, which is used in the treatment of gout. Which enzyme is catalyzing this reaction? Write down the condition associated with the accumulation of sorbitol. So glucose is converted to the sorbitol. So this step is catalyzed by aldol reductase, and sorbitol gets accumulated in uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, and it leads to diabetic cataract. Write the composition of Barfoot's reagent and its role. The first composition of Barfoot's reagent is copper acetate, which provides Cu+2. Second component is glacial acetic acid, which provides acidic medium. So these are the composition of Barfoot's reagent. Write the composition of Benedict's reagent and role of each components in reaction. So the composition of Benedict's reagent are, first one is sodium citrate, second one is sodium carbonate, and the third one is copper sulfate. Sodium citrate chelates the Cu+2 and releases it slowly for the reduction, which also acts as a stabilizing agent. Sodium carbonate, it provides alkaline medium, and the copper sulfate, it provides cupric ion. And copper is reduced to produce green, yellow, orange or red precipitate. Depending upon the amount of sugar present in the solution, Benedict's reagent gives different color precipitate ranging from green, yellow, red to brick red. Name the sulfur containing amino acids and the test done for the identification of it. So the sulfur containing amino acids are the cysteine and methionine, and it is identified by the lead acetate test. Methionine will give negative lead acetate test because thioether linkage which is present in the methionine is strong, and the sulfur in methionine cannot be split off to form sulfide. Write down the test for identification of arginine and write its principle. So arginine is identified by Sakaguchi test. It is given by compound containing guanidine group, and this test is given positive by arginine. Alpha naphthol reacts with guanidine group in alkaline medium, which then gets oxidized to form a red color. What are furfural derivatives and write basis of the reaction? So the furfural derivatives are produced when monosaccharides treated with concentrated H2SO4 undergo dehydration with the removal of 3 molecules of water. Therefore, hexose is, that is D-glucose, give hydroxymethyl furfural, and the pentose is, that is D-ribose, give furfural. The furfural derivative can condense with phenolic compounds, that is alpha naphthol, to give colored products, that is purple or violet complex. This forms the basis of Molis test, which is the general test of carbohydrates. Name the test for the identification of aromatic amino acid and write its principle. Answer is xanthoprotic test. This test is given positive by phenylalanine, tyrosine and tryptophan, which are the aromatic amino acids. The phenyl ring present in aromatic amino acids undergo nitration when treated with concentrated HNO3 at high temperature to produce yellow colored derivatives of nitrobenzene, which turn into orange in alkaline medium. That is the principle of xanthoprotic test, which is done for the detection of phenylalanine, tyrosine and tryptophan. What is FBS, PP2BS and RBS and write its normal range. So FBS is the fasting blood sugar. For the fasting blood sugar, we require 10 to 12 hours of fasting. PP2BS is the postprandial blood sugar. The sample for the PP2BS is collected after 2 hours of meal, and the random blood sugar, you can collect the sample at any time. Normal range of FBS is 70 to 100 mg per deciliter, RBS is 80 to 140 mg per deciliter and PP2BS is up to 140 mg per deciliter. Write the test included in liver function test and its normal range. In the liver function test, tests are included. First one is SGPT, second one is SGOT, third one is alkaline phosphatase, fourth one is bilirubin, then fifth one is albumin. And the normal range of SGPT, which is also known as ALT in the male, is 5 to 40 international unit per liter. In the female, it is 0 to 25 international unit per liter. Normal range of SGOT, which is also known as AST, in the males is 10 to 49 international unit per liter, and in the female, it is 0 to 31 international unit per liter. And the normal range of ALP is 80 to 160. This is the normal range of total direct and indirect bilirubin, and the normal range of albumin is 3.5 to 5 gram per deciliter. Write the test included in renal function test and its normal range. So the test included in RFT are urea, creatinine and uric acid. And the normal range of urea is 15 to 40 mg per deciliter, and the normal range of blood urea nitrogen is 10 to 18 mg per deciliter. Normal range of creatinine in the male is 0.7 to 1.4 mg per deciliter, and in the female is 0.4 to 1.2 mg per deciliter. The normal range of uric acid in the male is 3 to 7, while in the female is 2 to 5 mg per deciliter. Calculation of clearance test. So calculate the creatinine clearance of urine sample with the following observation. U is equal to 100 mg per deciliter, V is equal to 1.2 ml per minute and P is equal to 1 mg per deciliter. So put this value into the formula, that is U multiplied by V divided by P, where U is urinary creatinine, V is the rate of urine flow and the P is the serum or plasma creatinine. So by putting all these three values into this formula, you can calculate the creatinine clearance. And the normal range of creatinine clearance in the male is 85 to 125 ml per minute, and in the female it is 80 to 115 ml per minute. Calculate the AG ratio and write its normal range. And the value given are total protein is 6.5 and albumin is 3.4. So we all know that total protein is equal to albumin plus globulin. So we know the value of total protein and albumin. So globulin is equal to serum total protein minus serum albumin. So from this we get the value of serum globulin. So we can calculate the AG ratio by multiplying the value of albumin by globulin. So this is the AG ratio, and the normal range of AG ratio is 1.2:1 to 2.5:1. So this is all about the sporting and image based questions which are frequently asked in biochemistry practical examination. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit, and don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it.